Welcome to the Flying Circus of Physics. Hi, I'm Jearl Walker. I'm one of the physics professors here at Cleveland State University. We're right outside the science building where I have my office. I'm standing in the shadow of the science building. And by being in the shadow, I cannot cast my own shadow. But I want to show you something. I'm going to move right over here. There's my shadow. My shadow should be out there in the sunshine. But what's causing this? There's a reflection off a dorm room window high up there. Now, I don't feel any heat, extra heat, from that light that's reflecting down from me, because that's just one window, one window's reflection. But wonder if I had a bunch of windows reflecting light to almost the same spot. I think the sensation would be far more in that case. I know a place on campus where that happens. We're on the other side of Berkman Hall, where we have our classrooms, and we have a wall windows up there. The wall is curved, and in one place it's concave. We're getting reflections from the windows into one spot down here. I can see my shadow from the reflections down here on the pavement. I'm going to measure the temperature of this area that's catching the reflected rays by using this remote temperature gauge. First, I'll do it over here where there is no reflection from the windows. 120 degrees. And now, area where there is reflection from the windows, 122 degrees and climbing. I can feel the heat on the back of my neck from the reflection of those windows, reflecting in almost the same spot. This reminds me of the legend of Archimedes in defending the city of Syracuse in Sicily about 200 BC. The Roman fleet was coming in. It was up to Archimedes to defeat that fleet. What could he do? According to legend, he had hundreds of soldiers lined up on the shore with their shiny metal shields, angled just right to send reflections to a given ship so that ship would catch on fire and start burning. He defeated enough ships like that, according to legend, that the Romans turned around and retreated. Let's see if we could have a death ray like that ourselves.
Death ray.
I've got a model of a Roman ship here. I want to somehow create my own death ray to mimic Archimedes. I want to set this ship on fire to force the Romans to retreat. But I don't have hundreds of soldiers around me with shiny shields. I need something else. I need a large mirror. That's what I need. I got a mirror. Look, I got a mirror. I can make my own death ray now. I can set this ship on fire. I can defeat the Romans like Archimedes in the legend did. Let's see it happen. I think I need to be safe with this because it's going to be a really good reflector of the sunlight. I'm going to back away for a little bit and then I'll work my way up to the ship. Okay, I'm kind of far away. I think it's safe enough. This is going to be a bright reflection, but no, the angle's not right. I need to try something else. Oh, the angle's still not right. I'm not going to burn the ship this way. I got to think about this. This is just optics. Let me try it over here. This is getting a lot better. But I've got to get the mirror pointed toward the sun with a boat on the line straight toward the sun. And then maybe I can put the focal point right on the boat and I got a chance of burning the boat. Let's see if I can do this. Will be defeated today. Archimedes' death ray recreated. Burning. Wood's being charred. See if we can hold the focal point right on the spot. And that boat is burning. There goes open flame. Hooray! Archimedes' death ray recreated, defeating the Romans. Open flames. How exciting. I didn't want to burn down too much. I'd get in trouble here on campus, but I wanted to show you the Archimedes death ray. Thanks for coming. This is Flying Circus of Physics. Hope to see you next time. Just remember, physics is everywhere, even in reflections. Now, if I'm in the shadow of the science building, I can't Okay, here we go.